Okay. All right. We're back here. And, Jerry and Matt, third section of these videos for Tuesday, the 6th. All right. And we're probably going to close. I'll probably just do three videos today, for now. Being as tired as we are and what's going on, other things. So, yeah. Can't always say that it might be just three. It might be more later. And one of us thinks about doing more if something happens. You know how it goes. But,
I have to pop into our minds and stuff.
and we just take action. Ideas, we don't wait till the next day, usually we just try to get it done, but it's so funny because after the last video where we were talking about spiritual paths and not worrying about money and people worrying about money and intuition, kind of all came to play with the phone and a friend of mine calling and what he was thinking about.
Mine too.
And Jeremy had the same issue with another one of his friends. The moment we finished talking about it, the video cut the camera off. That's something they told me, well, if you turn the incoming call capability back on the phone, which I turn off when I'm filming videos on the phone, I turn the calling capability back on, Tony's going to call right away. And the moment I put it on, it rang with Tony calling. So, and not only that, he's talking about that he'd been anxious and worried about money. The past few days, this similar thing that happened. He knew who was going to call beforehand, and the same thing that happened to me.
Everybody's worried about money today, but I guess every day people are discouraged and feel like money is the answer to everything. And I guess money can be an answer for a bit, like I said, but it doesn't last forever.
That's right.
If it doesn't last forever, it's not pure.
That's right. You're right about that, you know? Yeah. But, let's see what we talk about here, What can we talk about, See, sometimes it's just, some days are just a little bit more slower than others on ideas.
Yeah, definitely. What can we touch on? I don't know. We could, I don't know, I just could say hey to some people, man,
Yeah.
Definitely, we'll get to that.
Get to that the last part of this.
Say, definitely, one thing we were going to touch on more is about how, name brands and things like
oh,
that.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
Yeah, like what we were talking about the last couple minutes of the last video. Yeah, name brands are like, name brand clothing especially is just almost like absurd.
I mean, I always said that, it's funny because, and I know this doesn't apply to peas in general. Because some people have a certain type of peas that they really like. But, when I think about peas, I mean, the peas come out the vine, peas come out, they put them in a can. Okay, they're peas, But what if they have a different label on them? Somebody's looking at the two different types of peas and they're going, I'll go for this one because it's better, It's got a better name brand on it. But they're all peas, They all come from the same earth and the same plant. Now, like I said, I said that one time before to somebody and they said, well, I like this kind of peas. I didn't even know people actually had preferences on peas. So it doesn't apply to everybody, but the same kind of thing, with the clothes, it really is a status thing.
That's all it is. It's like a status symbol, buying expensive clothes and all this stuff. I knew a guy that I grew up with, that was obsessed about buying new clothes and shoes all the time. You know what I'm talking about. And I'm constantly obsessed about this wardrobe and looking fashion and all this crazy shit.
Yeah, I wanted to show me his wardrobe, like, look what I have. And I was kind of felt like, well, that's great,
We're not friends anymore, speaking of that.
No,
have I've been for years.
Yeah,
he left me. He don't hang out with me.
Right.
And vice versa.
Same with
me. He could have wanted to be around me for what some reason.
Same with me. So.
Hey, we talked to his parents. Parents are dead.
Yeah.
So they're not dead. I don't like to use the word dead because of the connotations of that. You know, people think dead, they think cease to be and destroy.
Yeah.
But we chat with his parents all the time on the other side. They come through. Good discussion.
Yeah.
Talking about him and his sister,
yeah,
about what's really going on. Yeah.
Interesting how people get so caught up in their clothes and their shoes and, you know, all that stuff. It's just ridiculous.
Yeah, shoe thing and the clothes. I don't know. I've never, all my life, I felt like this. I never really thought that. I mean, like me, like it's like Jeremy's outfit is that he's got his hat, his shirt, t-shirt, hat, sunglasses. Me, it's my long hair and my outfit. Long hair, sunglasses, and baggy white coat and jeans usually, you know, and polo shirts.
That's
polo
right.
Type shirts or whatever. Not necessarily polo brand, but same idea, my
yeah.
Design. You know,
yeah.
That's my outfit. It's been my outfit like that for years. That's what I seem to that's my uniform.
I'll show the audience a picture of you when I was a kid. How about that?
I think it'll show okay. This is me when I was a kid playing the guitar. I'm about 6, maybe 8 at the oldest. I got my hat on.
Always wore the hat. Always had the hat. That's my logo. That's my copyright that one day. it's something that my grandfather gave me a hat when I was a kid. And it meant a lot to me. I wore it until I lost it. I bought another one. I wore it until I lost that one and bought another one. Just kept buying hats like this, you know. So maybe you recognize me or Matt by the hair of the hat and sunglasses. Always say the hair and the hat. Two H's, we got the four
hair
H's,
now
we got the two H's, and
we're
hair and a hat.
I get recognized all the time. I get, like, I mean, I can't tell you, like, how many people have come up to me asking them what shampoo I use for my hair and say, oh, your hair is so beautiful, man.
Yeah.
With a natural color,
well,
which it is natural color, natural blonde.
I'll give an example. One time we were walking down Broad Street. And a homeless lady came up to Madman, was rubbing his hair, and just, oh, you have such beautiful hair, and all this. And, we were talking to all kinds of people.
We were talking to all kinds of people that day.
Yeah.
We were
just walking the street, yeah.
Walking the streets of Richmond downtown.
Yeah.
Just all walks of life of people. The first thing that happened when we got down there that day, first person we encountered was a woman who ran up to us, and she's like, y'all are psychic.
Yeah,
you know, that's out of nowhere. See, y'all was psyched.
Like, how did she know? I don't know, but she come running up and said it, and it was like, yes, we are. Yes, we are.
Yeah.
And, like, she just kept on.
I was like, you're correct.
Yeah, she just kept trucking. She just kept on going. And, the homeless lady gave Matt a cigar when he offered her some cigarettes, you know, which
yeah.
I thought was kind, because she probably didn't have that many cigars. But,
little cigarillo type thing.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Little small brown cigarette looking one.
She definitely liked Matt's hair, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
I remember telling her she was beautiful because I know she wanted to feel that way. People comment on the hat all the time. They always say, you know, nice bowler, nice derby, you know, whatever, you know, they would call it. You know, so if I want to be incognito, you know, I have to take it off. You know, I'll walk around with my hair. You know, a lot of people don't recognize my hair, especially if I take my sunglasses off, and, you know, but that's our trademark, man.
Yeah, that's you're right. You're 100% right. I mean, like, I like my long hair,
yeah.
You know. I've had all my hair cut off before in the past, cut it all off, you know, down to, like, almost down to the skin a lot of times.
Okay.
Had short, you know, had it medium length, all different ways, had it braided, had cornrows in. Different times. Now, I wish I had some pictures of that here.
Yeah.
Like, you know, I got lots of compliments on the cornrows. I remember that. When those were in, people were stopping me saying, like, that looks good, you know?
Right.
That looks good on your hair, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, they never down to here, past my shoulders and arms, the fat just hanging down. They're long, long, long.
We've seen each other go through a lot of different styles, you know, as far as haircuts and these go. you know, throughout the years. I know Matt's 13, I'm 31 years old now, so you can imagine how long that's been, you know.
Yeah, it's been a while, yeah.